A warm hello to all my dentist friends. I am Dr. Sheetal Kotni, a proud alumnus from Manipal College of Dental Sciences, Manipal. Currently, I'm pursuing my post-graduation at the Department of Conservative Dentistry and Endodontics from Kalinga Institute of Dental Sciences, Bhubaneswar. I have collaborated with the Dental Hub in order to make a presentation about the most widely used impression material. Yes, you guessed that right. The alginate impression material. In case of any doubts, kindly mention in the comments below. Enjoy!
Alginate impression material. Before we dive into it, let's know what an impression is. An impression is a negative replica of the tissue. A cast is the positive replica of upper and lower jaw, which serves the purpose of construction of various restoration. Positive replication of the form of the prepared tooth in form of an individual tooth constitutes an individual die. So what should a good impression contain? The good impression material should be homogeneously uniformly blent. The material should be uniformly spread over the entire tray without too much material overflowing. No tray surface should be shown through the impression material. There should be no tooth contact with the tray. Details of the prepared tooth surface with margin should be visible. Part of the unprepared tooth margin adjacent to the prepared margin should be visible. No voids or pulls on margin detail. Alginate. According to American Dental Association, the specification number of alginate is number 18. It is based on a natural substance that is alginic acid derived from marine brown alga. It is an irreversible elastic hydrocolloid impression material. Coming to its composition, it contains sodium or potassium salts of alginic acid in 15%, which are the main reactive substances which form sol with water and then cross-link with calcium. Calcium sulfate dihydrate in 16% controls the rate at which cross-linking cations are released. Diatomaceous earth increases the strength and stiffness. Trisodium phosphate in 2% is the retarder. Potassium titanium fluoride is the accelerator. Coming to the characteristics of hydrocolloids. During impression making, the material sets from a flowable state to a solid state. This is called the sol-gel transformation. Now, what is a sol and what is a gel? A sol is a colloidal dispersion of very small particles in a continuous liquid medium, whereas a gel is a suspension that behaves like an elastic solid. If a hydrocolloid contains an adequate concentration of the dispersed phase, that is the sol, under certain conditions, it could change into a gel. In the gel state, the dispersed phase forms agglomerates in the form of chains or fibrils, also called micelles. So these fibrils may branch and intermesh to form a brush heap structure with capillary attraction or adhesion. So alginic acid is a linear copolymer of glucuronic acid and manuronic acid. Now, alginates with higher glucuronic acid bind higher to calcium, that is, their affinity to calcium is higher and the reaction occurs faster. So, the commercial alginates for impression making use manuronic acid. The types of alginates are traditional and modified. Traditional is the one which is supplied in all our colleges, that is the single component system. It is supplied as a powder to which water has to be added to initiate the reaction. Modified alginates has a two component system. Now, why was this modified alginates devised? Because traditional alginates have their own discrepancies, that is inconsistency in dispensing accurate amounts of powder, separation of ingredients, contamination, etc. In order to counter these disadvantages, alginate in the form of a two-paste system has been introduced. So this contains a paste-forming material in the base paste. Also, the reactor or catalyst paste contains calcium salt mixed with viscous liquid. The two-component system has one component with alginate in the form of sol and the other component contains calcium reactor. It is supplied both in syringe and tray viscosity. Properties of type 1 and type 2. Type 1 is the traditional and type 2 is the two-paste system. Now, type 1's gelation time is shorter than type 2. Other than that, all their properties are comparable. The elastic recovery being 97%, flexibility 5 to 20%, gel strength greater than 0.34, tear strength 300 to 700 gram per centimeter square, and disinfection with iodophore immersion. Dimensional stability, it is unstable because of cinereces and imbibition. Setting reaction. So the potassium alginate, which was present in the alginate powder in dispersion with water and on reaction with calcium sulfate, forms potassium sulfate and calcium alginate, which is the main product. But when alginate powder is mixed with water, the sodium and potassium salts of alginic acid readily dissolve to give an alkaline solution. So we need to achieve a delay in order to give a good working time. So this delay is achieved by the addition of phosphates, which consumes the calcium released from alginate as it dissolves in water. Once all the phosphate is taken up, the still releasing calcium ions then take part in the reaction to form calcium alginate, and setting starts suddenly. Control of setting time. So setting time control is by retarders like trisodium phosphate and by cooling of bowl and spatula, that is to prevent premature gelation. Manipulation. We have all done this manipulation in our dental material classes, but sometimes some of us might be having difficulty in the figure eight motion. So first we start with proportioning, followed by a final figure eight powder water mixing, and then loading from posterior part of the tray to anterior, followed by recording, then removal with a single sudden jerk, followed by washing and disinfection with iodophore, then casting immediately, otherwise a gap of 1 hour in humid environment is permissible. Beyond that, it shouldn't be permissible. A perforated stainless steel or plastic tray can be used, since the alginate flows through these perforations and helps in a good retention form and prevents separation of impression material from the tray during the removal from mouth. So you can see proportioning, followed by mixing and scraping the alginate against the bowl so that to remove any voids present. And at the end, this should be the mix, which is, should be smooth and creamy. Coming to gypsum compatibility, the water content, borax, sodium salt in impression inhibits the setting of gypsum at the surface. So these discrepancies can be resolved by adding a gypsum accelerator, that is potassium titanium fluoride in alginate. Advantages are easy to manipulate. It is hydrophilic, therefore it does not require a dry field for impression making. Some disadvantages are that it does not reproduce the finer details of oral tissues that are required for proper fabrication of the restoration. A slight variation in water powder ratio has a significant effect on the tear strength and the elasticity of impression material. Coming to its uses, it is used to obtain study casts, to obtain preliminary study cast for fabrication of prosthesis and orthodontic purposes, as a preliminary impression to construct a custom tray for a more accurate secondary impression, to take impressions for fabrication of temporaries for indirect restoration. Now, hydrocolloid impressions. Hydrocolloid impressions include both agar and alginate. So I will be just discussing why there should be a good disinfection protocol. So due to their properties of imbibition and cineresis, the impression should not be left immersed in the liquid disinfectant. Rather, a spray could be used, iodophore, sodium hypochlorite or synthetic phenols. Glutaraldehyde is not recommended for hydrocolloids. The time of exposure is 10 minutes. Hence, after removal of impression from the mouth, it is washed thoroughly with water, sprayed with disinfectant, wrapped in a paper towel soaked in the disinfectant and sealed in a plastic bag for the time period of disinfection. Coming to its failure and how to get a good remedy for the failure. If the alginate impression has grainy look, it might be due to a prolonged mixing or a too less water powder ratio. This could be corrected by a proper mixing and the proper water powder ratio according to the manufacturer's instruction. Tearing, it could be because of less material used, could be moisture contamination, premature removal and prolonged mixing. Remedy is, tray should be held in mouth till complete gelation. 45 seconds should be held in mixing. External bubbles, Now, external bubbles could be due to undergelation or air incorporated during mixing. Now, mixing should be supped between the blade of the spatula and the walls of the bowl. Rough or chalky stone cast could be because of inadequate cleaning, excess water, premature removal, prolonged model duration in impression. Remedy is impression to be cleaned under running tap water. Excess water should be shaken off. Cast to be separated after 30 minutes. Distortion. When the impression is not poured immediately or tray removed early or late, the remedy could be immediate impression pour and single jerk after gelation. Now, some of the modifications of alginate which make all of our lives easier are: one is dust-free alginate, which prevents carcinogenesis or fibrinogenesis to prolonged dust inhalation, that is silicosis. This is by addition of a de-dusting agent, glycol. Siliconized alginate, this improves the tear strength by incorporating a silicon polymer. Alginate in the form of a sol, this is to minimize the technique sensitivity. Therefore, a two-paste system, which I had mentioned before. Alginate containing indicators, so this helps to indicate the different stages of manipulation. Color indicators are involved. Alginate with a disinfectant. So disinfectant is incorporated within the material, that is ammonium salts. This is the manipulation of colorful alginates. So one of the commercial name is Tropicalgin. So it has different colors at different stages of manipulation, at the time of dispensing, placing, loading, and removal. So I hereby like to conclude that even though alginate seems as a simple material to use in case of absence of mind or incorrect manipulation, the material or the impression could fail. Hence, an adequate impression makes all of our lives easier. Thank you.